Today we are going to discuss conversion of percentage and decimal and rounding off. First topic we are going to discuss is conversion of percentage into decimal. Here are some example of this topic. Number one is 25% and we want this percentage conversion into decimal. You have to follow two steps to convert a percentage into decimal. Number one, 25%. If you want to convert this percentage into decimal, you will follow step number one. You will firstly convert this percentage into fractional number. You cannot convert directly percentage into decimal number. You will follow the instruction, step one and step two. Firstly, you will convert this percentage into fractional number, and after that, you will convert this into decimal number. 25%, step one is 25/100. Percentage. The sign of percentage is equal to divided by 100. If you want to remove this percentage sign, you will write 100 as the denominator. And you know how to convert this fractional number into a decimal number. If you have two zeros in the denominator, it means you will place the decimal point before two numbers. And you don't have any number before two numbers, that's why you will put zero here. Number two example is 165%. Again, you will follow two steps to find the decimal number. Step one is 165/100. You will remove the percentage sign. That's why you are placing the denominator 100 here. And step 2, 1.65. You have two zeros in the denominator. That's why you are placing the decimal point before two numbers. 1.65 is the answer. Now comes to the second topic, conversion of decimal into percentage. Number one example is 1.25. You want to convert this decimal number into percentage. Again, you will follow two steps to convert this decimal number into percentage. 1.25. If you want to convert this decimal number, firstly you will remove this decimal point. And you know, if you want to remove this decimal point, you will write the denominator according to the numbers after the decimal point. If you have two digits after the decimal point, you will write 100 as the denominator. Step 2 is you have to find the value of 1.25 as a percentage. Step 2 is you will multiply this fractional number by 100%. Why are you multiplying this number by 100%? You know, if you multiply any number with 1, the answer will remain same. That's why I am multiplying this fractional number by 100%. 100% equals to 1. I know that. Why I am saying that 100% equals to 1? 100 percentage means divided by 100. 100 ones are 100. 100 ones are 100 equals to 1. 125/100 multiply by 100%. 100% equals to 1. Remember this. 100 cancel out, 125% is the answer. Number two example, 49.5. Again, you will remove the decimal point. 49.5, if you will remove this decimal point, you have only one digit after the decimal point. That's why you will write 10 as the denominator. Number two step, you will multiply this fractional number by 100%. 495 divided by 10 multiplied by 100%, 0, 0 cancel. 495 multiplied by 10%, 4950% is the answer. Approximate values of the numbers. If there are too many decimal places in a decimal fraction, it becomes difficult to make a mathematical calculations. A lot of time is also spent in writing them out. It becomes easier if we know how to find approximate values. This is often called rounding off to a desired number of decimal places to get an approximate value of the original number. We have some examples here. Example number one, 5.2143 to 8.9761, 0.8241. We want these decimal number as the nearest whole number. To convert this decimal number into a whole number, we will observe number right after the decimal point. If the number is less than 5, it means we will not add 1 in the number. The number after the decimal point is 2, that's why I am dropping all the number after the decimal point. 5 is the answer. The number after the decimal point is 9. That's why I am adding 1 to 8, which is equals to 9, and dropping all the number after the decimal point. In this example, the number after the decimal point is 8. That's why I am adding 1 to 0, which is equals to 1, and dropping all the number after the decimal point. Now comes to approximate value of the numbers correct to two decimal places. To convert this decimal number approximation correct to two decimal places,
I will observe this number, which is the third decimal place number. And this number is less than 5. That's why I am not adding 1 in this digit and dropping these two numbers. 5.21 is the answer. 8.9761. I want 2 decimal places in the answer. That's why I am observing the third decimal place, which is greater than 5. I am adding 1 to 7. 8.98 is the answer and dropping these two numbers. 0.8241, I am observing this number, which is the third decimal place, and this number is less than 5. That's why I am dropping these two numbers without adding 1 to 2. 0.82 is the answer of this number.